This is a picture of a scene that is going to take place someday in heaven at the throne of God. You see, you can't change your past, but you can determine your destiny by deciding for Christ. And when you do that, Christ changes your past. He wipes out all the sins of the past.
If you gotta start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now.
Republicans aren't gonna be able to fix it. Democrats aren't going to be able to fix it. The only hope for this country is God. Okay? And the only hope, not only God, but God's people. And I want us to pray tonight. Tonight I'm going to give you an invitation. If you're here tonight and you're not sure that your sins are forgiven, if you're here tonight, if you're not sure that if you died, if God would receive you into his presence, today, this evening, you can be sure. I'm going to give you an opportunity in just a few moments to take a stand wherever you're sitting and to take a stand for Jesus Christ, to ask him to forgive your sins and by faith to invite him to come into your heart, into your life. But tonight I'm going to give you that opportunity. But I want you to listen about almost being saved. It was the same in the days of Lot. People were eating, drinking, buying and selling, planting, building. But the day Lot left Sodom, fire and sulfur rained down. It will be just like this on the day that the Son of Man is revealed. Remember Lot's wife. Now, there have been movies and books written about Armageddon, the last battle on earth. Revelation 16, 16 is generally thought to be the plains of Jezreel, west of the Jordan River. Between Galilee and Samaria. It has come to be the symbol of the last war of history, after which many believe that Christ will come. The Bible says the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night. The heavens will disappear with a roar, the elements will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything in it will be laid bare. Why did Jesus tell us to remember Lot's wife? You see, Lot was Abraham's nephew. He had been down to Egypt. They'd come back to Canaan. And both Abraham and Lot became very wealthy. And there's dangers of riches and affluence. Affluence often brings spiritual poverty in one's life. The Bible says it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says, woe to you that are rich, for you have already received your comfort. Woe to you who are well fed now, for you will be hungry. Lot and Abraham became extremely wealthy. And the herdsman, Sodom, and he sees you here tonight. They had a false sense of security. They had scientific achievement, military power. They had economic strength. But they sought sinful pleasure. They were involved in sex and perverted sex, and there's pleasure of sin for a short time, the Bible warns. They were too busy for God. Have you been too busy for God? Everybody does it, you just say to yourself. I mean, society has changed. Everybody is doing the same thing, so it can't be that bad. We're all doing it. Sin is sin. God's going to judge sin. Is there something missing in your life? Is there a sense of guilt? The reason is because of our sins. You see, I grew up in a Christian home, went to church, but I As guys went through my teenage years, I didn't want God in my life. It wasn't that I didn't believe in God. I did. I just didn't want him telling me what to do. I wanted to have fun. And I didn't care what my parents thought. I was going to do what I thought pleased me, what would make me happy. And there were things I could do, and I would be happy for a time, but there was this emptiness in my life. And maybe some of you are at that point tonight. I just got to the place in my own life where I became sick and tired of just being sick and tired. Have you ever been there? I was just, that's where I was. And I just one night got on my knees. I said, God, I've sinned against you. And I'm sorry. Forgive me. I believe that Jesus Christ is your son. I believe that he died for my sins, that you raised him to life. And I would like to invite him to come into my heart. And I would like for him tonight to take the pieces of my broken, busted life. And if he can somehow put it together and make sense of it, I surrender my life to you. Fire and brimstone came. You see, their sins had gone up to God. God had seen and heard what they were doing. And God was bringing judgment. But he wanted to save his own. Don't look back. Don't look back. And Jesus said, remember Lot's wife. See, she looked back. She was the wife of Abraham, nephew Lot. She had lived in Abraham's tent. Many times she had seen God's hand at work. She had seen the blessings of God poured out on Abraham and her husband. She knew these things. But remember her sin. It seems like such a small thing. Just all she did was just glance back. It only takes one sin to keep you out of heaven. Did you know that? Just one sin. And the Bible says all of us have sinned. And you say, but Frank, I've lived a good life. I try to help everybody, try to do good things. That's wonderful. But you're still a sinner. And you see, Lot's wife, the angels warned, don't turn back. Don't look back. It seemed like such a small thing. But it represented something far deeper. It represented unbelief over many years. It represented rebellion against God on many occasions. God in his mercy was giving her another chance. Flee for your life. Don't look back. And God is giving you another chance tonight. It's your choice. Remember, she was almost saved. She was at the gates of Zoar, the city of refuge. A few more steps, she would have been safe. Remember, she was offered salvation. Tonight, you're being offered salvation. Christ is the place of our security. Christ, the place where we are safe. There neither is salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. The Bible says we've all sinned and come short of God's glory, that the penalty of sin is death. You say, but Franklin, what do you mean by sin? Telling a lie is a sin. Have you ever lied? Oh, well, a little white lie. Oh, really? A lie is a lie. You're guilty. Well, you say, well, Franklin, I've never lied. Well, now you're lying now. Oh, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life. You see, Jesus Christ came from heaven to this earth on a rescue mission. He came to save you from your sins. He came and he took your penalty. The Bible says the penalty for sin is death. But God so loved you that he sent his son to take the sting of death for you. Jesus Christ went to the cross. When he was on the cross, when he was nailed on the cross, God poured out on his son all the sins past. He poured out on his son all the sins present. He poured out on his son all the sins future. That's us here tonight. Jesus Christ willingly went to the cross. He died and shed his blood on the cross. He was buried for our sins. That's not the end. The third day came. And on the third day, God said, it's enough. On the third day, God raised his son from the grave. Jesus Christ is not dead. He's alive. He's here tonight in Bakersfield. He's here tonight. And if you're willing tonight to say, God, I have sinned, confess it, that's confession. God, I have sinned, and I'm sorry. I want to turn from my sin. That's called repentance. I'm willing to leave my sin and by faith to believe on the name of your son, Jesus Christ, and I want him to come into my heart. And I believe that you raised him to life. God will forgive your sins tonight. He'll heal your heart. He'll give you a new life and a new beginning. You can have a new start. But you're going to have to do that tonight. I want you to stand to your feet. And then we're going to have a word of prayer together. If you would like to have your sins forgiven, just stand to your feet. Wherever you are, just stand up. And when we've all stood, we're going to have a word of prayer. By standing. By standing. You're saying to God, I'm a sinner. By standing, you're saying to God,
wash it for me.
If you don't remember anything else, I want you to remember this. God loves you. But Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. There's not many roads to God. There's only one. And that's through Christ. Because he's the only one in history to take our sins. That's how much God loves you. He sent his son to take your sins. He died in your place. And God raised him to life. And I'd like to lead you right now in a prayer. And I want you to just repeat this prayer out loud after me. For those of you who are standing, I want you to repeat this prayer out loud after me. Dear God, I am a sinner. I'm sorry for my sins. Forgive me. I want to turn from my sins. I invite Jesus to come into my heart. I surrender my life to him. I want to follow him for the rest of my life. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay? Because God's not going to bring them up. You don't have to bring them up. You've been cleansed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ here tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
God has now recorded your name in another book. It's called the Lamb's Book of Life. And he's written that name, your name, with the blood of his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, because you've been purchased by his blood. He made you, he created you, but we were lost to sin, but you've been redeemed by the power of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want you to go to church. I want you to tell the pastor what you did here. I want you to get involved in a Bible study. Let me just say
Let's
something.
Just have a word of prayer.
Father, I thank you for each one that has come tonight. Father, I pray for them, for their families, for those that they love. Father, I pray that they would get involved in a church, that you would bring somebody along them to help them and disciple them and answer their questions. Father, we thank you for your son, Jesus Christ. Thank you for sending this earth to take our sins to the cross. Father, I pray for those that have stood now. Watch over them and protect them. We pray for them, their families, and all those that they love. Father, it's my prayer that all of them not only will continue to walk and serve with you, but their families as well. And we thank you and we praise you and we give you the glory. It's in Jesus' name. Amen.
Upon not only the king, but all the people, and all the people were saved. That could happen here.
Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints to world collide in a glorious display. Cause it's all love tonight. When we step across the line, we can sail across the sea to a city.
Somebody here worthy. He is the lion, the root of David, hath prevailed to receive a new heart from him. I ask you to come tonight.
I'm going to ask you to get up out of your seat all over this great auditorium and come and stand quietly and reverently here in front as an indication that you're receiving Christ, that you want a new heart and a new life from this moment on, that you're going to change the direction of your life. The Holy Spirit has been speaking. He's been preparing your heart. Now you come and receive Christ.